everyone. Okay, today we're going to focus on a show that gets overlooked a lot in terms of being a rock musical and in terms of being, like, true to life about the way kids really are. Like, sometimes they have shows that are about kids, and it's like, really? Kids are like that? Kids do triple pirouettes and full splits? I mean, I did, but a lot of other kids did not. And this show's fantastic. Anyway, it's called Runaways by Elizabeth Suedo. She pretty much did everything, like music, lyrics, book, direction, lighting design. Anyway, it was from the late 70s, and it's a great, great, great score. So I want to play some stuff for you. The first thing we're going to play is Guess This Actress. This is called No Lullabies for Louie, and it's devastating. Essentially, she's walking her friend around who's like having a heroin overdose, and she's trying to keep him awake so he doesn't fall asleep and literally die. But that's not the point of this. It's just guess who this actress is. Okay, here we go. Canción de cuna, Louis. Canción de cuna, Louis. Canción de cuna, Louis. Canción de cuna, Louis. Anybody? Anybody? Okay, she was in an amazing, enormous hit show like 13 years later. I will play you a little snippet of her.
It is nice
number
to know.
45.
Oh, when my love comes along, I won't take a chance. For
Josie de Guzman. But she was Josie, J-O-S-S-I-E de Guzman, late 70s. And she was Josie de Guzman, 1S, early 90s. Just saying. Okay, next I'm going to play one of my absolute favorite songs. It's Trini Alvarado. Anybody know who she is? She's, oh my God, the coolest voice, like a little bit raspy, a little bit I need my asthma inhaler, yet phenomenal. Great vibrato. It's called Lullaby from Baby to Baby. I was obsessed with the song the first time I ever heard it. Okay, here we go. I love this song.
The sun is rising in the smoky sky. The place is any city. In a house, a door opens and closes goodbye. The atmosphere won't be the same because baby's running from mama. Baby's a runaway. Tomorrow will be a different world than the way it was today.
Love that song, but I'll play just, I'm going to skip to the next verse. The chorus sings, and they sing Trini Alvarado, and then they're forced, what I'm obsessed with is they're forced to back themselves up. You'll hear, but like, they sing the melody, and they sing their own backup. Plus, I love Trini's placement on Tomorrow Will Be, it's such great placement. Tomorrow, oh my God, I love the clearness of that. Tomorrow, oh my God.
He's a runaway. Tomorrow will be a different world than the way it was today.
Fabulous song. Okay, now I'm going to play a song. It's right at the end of the show, Lonesome of the Road. It's just a great song, but I love that there's one girl in the chorus who is sassafrassing above everybody else. Everyone's singing harmony here, and she's like, I've got an amazing voice. I'm going to take my harmony up a fourth. And she's just constantly on top with a fast vibrato in the mask. Oh, she sounds so great. Okay, here we go. I'll point her out when she comes in.
Sitting on the
and worrying about.
again, finally, I'm ending with a devastating song. The song is so, it's so well written. It's, oh my God. It's called Song of a Child Prostitute. It was sung by, actually, Diane Lane. She was 13 years old, around 13 years old. And it's so cool. It's done, Elizabeth Sueda says she wrote it in a monotone because these child prostitutes are like drugged up and they're, it's almost like they're in a cult by their pimps, like, because they're given a lot of great things, but at the same time, they're also beaten. So it's similar to their home life, and they think that these pimps are, like, you know, going to take care of them for life, and they're just totally doled out. So the whole thing's in a monotone, and I did the show at Oberlin, and the score, the accompaniment was just, like, it gave you, like, five notes for the celeste and the flute, and it was just, like, move to the next note when you feel like it. Like, it's not really, it wasn't by measures. It was just sort of, like, at a certain point, you can move to the next note, and if you feel like it, move to this note. It's, I'm obsessed with the song, but it is devastating. I think it's so well written. Okay, let me just find it. Song of a Child Prostitute. I think it's 112.
Away from the Minnesota
street. Listen to these lyrics. Performance.
No one treats me like Nico do. He buys me halter tops and corkies. And he got me a waterbed. Up on our flat on Avenue C between 5th and 6th. He built great dreams and has a shepherd named Duke, so we're safe. All Nico says that we live in a free generation, and the man and the woman go into mutual enterprise. And sex is a business like kitchenware, lucrative, prosperous, and even humanitarian. If some middle-aged Judas in the offices can't get along with his family, I can make him feel like a daddy, I can make him feel like a daddy. Nico says a lay is a game. When I was a kid, my parents would check on me before they'd shoot up, and I'd pretend to be asleep. Nico says the same. Just pretend you feel good. Just pretend you feel good. Mostly everything works like clockwork, and I'll be Nico's number one girl forever. Or at least until I'm 16 and can get my learner's permit to drive to Montana to be a rancher. But for now, it's not bad. It's a little stretch to be someone's darling, to be someone's daughter, to be someone's sister, to pretend to be glad, to pretend to be glad. If the digital stopwatch that Nico bought me keeps working, I stay out of trouble. Legs open at 1, close at 7. I'm safe because Nico steals clothes from the men of the warehouse. I open at 1 minute, close at 7. If I ever go overtime, I catch hell. Once I met a guy who was a sailor. He was 18, he had acne, he was very sweet, he didn't do anything. He asked me to go to Ohio to live with his mother. When I asked him going after me, he said they don't want water beds, no more grass, no more pills in bright colors. He said I couldn't even be number one again. How could I be after I hurt him so bad? He needs me, he needs me. He made a deal to reward me. He says he's my percentage. He made a producer in all books and movies. I'm not yet 13, I used to go naked. And the men who touch me are college type actors. I'll pretend I'm a movie star. I'll pretend I'm an actress. I'll pretend I'm a college ball queen.
Come on, isn't that so effective? Oh my God, it's devastating. Okay, we have to cleanse the palate. Let's just end with something cheery for some reason. Here we go. No, you do. Let's cleanse the palate for fun. Peace out.